Hey, Jason Morrell here. Box and Whisker charts were a brand new chart type that came in XL 2016. Prior to that, you could create them, but you had to create a stacked column chart and then make your changes from there. And these days, there's a dedicated chart type for Box and Whisker. Now, statisticians love these. They'll jump out of bed in the morning to make these because they're very good for statistical analysis. Here's how you do them. So here we have some rainfall data, month by month, for the years 2000 through to 2017. Over here, we have an example of a Box and Whisker chart that's been generated from that data, at the top showing the legend for each of the years, and then down here, these are what Box and Whisker charts look like. So the X in the middle of the bar shows the median value for what we're looking at, which in this case is the average monthly data. The little line at the top indicates the maximum data value. The line at the bottom indicates the minimum data value. The beginning of the box here and the top of the box here represents the first and the third quartile in your data range. So statisticians quite often use this technique to show the regular range of data and any outliers that there may be in the data. I'm going to show you how I produce this Box and Whisker chart from the original data. So let's go back to here. Now what you need to do is to write some formulas for your data that works out your minimum and maximum values, your median value, and the value of the first and the third quartile. So down here, I'm going to add some extra rows to calculate those quickly. So firstly, just a label that says min, quartile 1, median, quartile 3, and maximum. Now, it doesn't really matter what they're called because you don't see those labels on the chart itself. In here, I'm going to use a function called quartile.inc. This formula, you specify a range of cells to look at that it's going to analyze, and then you specify a value between 0 and 4. That's five values, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. 0 represents min, 1 represents the first quartile, 2 represents median, 3 represents the third quartile, and 4 represents the maximum value of your data range. So yes, you could use min and max and the median functions if you want to, but just for simplicity, we might as well use the same function all the way through to generate the values for us. In this cell, I'm going to write the first formula using quartile.inc. Open the brackets. I'll continue up here so you can see what I'm doing. First of all, I select the range that I want to use. Now, because I want to copy this formula across the table in just a minute, I'm going to fix the row numbers by pressing F4 twice, but not fix the column letters, because that needs to change as I go across the table. Comma, then the quart is that value, 0 through to 4 that I mentioned before. Now, rather than typing in 0 and then having to change it to 1, 2, 3, and 4 for subsequent formulas, I'm going to use the row function and just pick a random cell on this row, let's say the one in column A, close the bracket, that's going to currently return 16. I'm then going to subtract 16 from the result to give me the 0. And 0, as you can see, represents the minimum value that's required for this quartile function. But as I copy this formula down to rows 17, 18, 19, and 20 in just a minute, that's going to calculate the values 1, 2, 3, and 4 in those subsequent cells. So let's close the bracket for the quartile function and press enter. That's the minimum value for this range of data. If I then autofill this down, not forgetting to fill without formatting, and then autofill the whole block across, and again, don't forget to fill without formatting. And what you get on each of these rows, the minimum value shows the smallest value in each data range for each column. The max shows the biggest, the median shows the median value, and so on. This is the data we're going to use for our Box and Whisker chart. Now, the range here is what I need for the chart data, but I also need to select the year numbers across the top so that it's got some labels in the chart. I then choose Insert, go to my charts gallery here. The Box and Whisker chart doesn't have its own icon here, but if you go to Recommended Charts, and then the All Charts tab, you've got full access to all of the chart types down here. And if you come down towards the bottom of the list, you'll find Box and Whisker. So let's choose that and click OK. And here's the chart you start with. So here's all your Box and Whisker data here. What I'm going to do just to make things easy to explain and to see is to move the chart to its own sheet. So Chart Tools, Design tab, click on Move Chart and put it on its own sheet. Now, initially, everything's bunched up in the middle. First thing I'd like to do is to spread those out. So if you double click anywhere on the chart, you'll get a side panel. And on the side panel, we get all the options to manipulate different bits of your chart. So I'm going to change this plot area options to any of these series. Any change you make here affects them all. So under series and then series options, I'm going to change that gap width from 75% down to something really low, like 5%. That way, it spreads everything out full width on your chart. And that's normally what you want. Chart title, obviously, needs to describe what the chart itself is doing. So just click in there and make your changes there. Make sure you describe what your chart is. The scale currently goes from 0 to 300. If you notice down the bottom end, everything kind of starts at about 35 to 40, and 250 here is the maximum value. So what I'm going to do is to go to the options over here and go right down to the bottom to where it says vertical value axis. And in here, if I choose the axis options and open that up, you'll see the minimum and maximum values. So I'm going to change the minimum to 25, the maximum to 275. And that way, you're kind of making more use of the vertical space available on your chart. Now, looking at the chart itself, these whiskers, as they're called, kind of stick out of the main block. These show the outliers, the maximum minimum values. And it helps you to spot things like over here, where we've got a value that's kind of way out of normal range. It helps you to spot those very quickly. The one last thing I'll probably put here, because there's nothing to indicate which year is which, and that's just a simple case of turning the legend on. So if I go to the chart element options here, switch the legend on here, and now you've got a color code representing your bars down here. You could also do it with data labels, but because there's 5 values per bar, if you want to include those and which year it is, it gets really busy down here. And that's why it's just best to keep the main chart simple, have a legend at the top indicating which color refers to which bar. So just to recap on some of the main points here. You need your data handy. You need to include or write some formulas to generate this extra data, calculating the minimum and maximum values for your data and your median value, and the first quartile and the third quartile values. Don't forget you can use the quartile.inc formula, specify your range, and specify the value 0, 1, 2, 3, or 4. Each of those numbers represents one of these options down the bottom. That means you can use the same formula all the way through to generate your values. Let me close this down. You then need to make sure that you select your years in this case, and these will appear as legend items on your chart, and also select your data, which forms the main basis for your chart. Then you go to the Insert tab, go to Recommended Charts and All Charts, and choose your Box and Whisker from here. From there, you just set your chart options as we've discussed before. Go get them.